and woke up early for us to give us your expertise.
Well, it's terrific to be here. Thanks very much for having me.
Did you have a favorite?
I did. You know, Ram Trucks, God Made a Farmer, really sort of connected with me. Very powerful.
I got a lump in my throat on that one.
Yeah, it was goosebumps for me, too.
Yeah, that was one that it was voiced by, well, it was a track from the late Paul Harvey, and it showed all these amazing images of these rugged farmers, even like a farmer's daughter, it looked like, and with him talking about it. And of course, they, you know, subtly put in the Ram trucks. Do you think this is one that will really pay dividends for Ram?
You know, I hope so. I think the best advertising always makes an emotional connection, and that obviously did, at least for me. You know, people connect with human ideals more so than product ideas, and I think the spots that we all enjoyed most yesterday, where they made us laugh or get goosebumps or tear up a little bit, really connected on an emotional level.
And when you think about hard work, I mean, if you want to connect your vehicle to someone who works hard, I don't think there are very many people who work harder than farmers, and so the connection made it really seem like these trucks are dependable. Farmers are dependable.
No doubt. And Jeep also paid tribute to soldiers, which was very impactful as well. We were talking about that earlier in the newscast. Audi, let's talk about Bravery, because that one was released ahead of time, got a lot of buzz, and you know, it was one of those where you could vote on the ending, right? The people online.
I don't know if this was a vote at the end one, but look,
it was,
I think,
memorable.
Yeah, it was very much memorable. I think it's, again, it tied into a simple human truth. You know, it tied into the fact that, you know, when you're behind the wheel of the right car, it can give you a sense of confidence without being heavy-handed with it. And being kind of a geeky high school kid myself, that obviously it connected with me.
Yeah, and he gets the keys from Dad. I mean,
yeah,
you know,
nice.
That is like a moment where you're like, I get the keys. And so you feel that. You feel being the underdog. And he goes into the prom, he gets the girl. I mean, he
lays one on her right here. Yeah. Who was it? Like the quarterback's like, after this moment?
The prom king.
He's like, wait, that's my girl.
Well, it kind of shows that, you know, I think in advertising as well as if you're the geek at the prom, Bravery can pay off in a big way.
Absolutely. Let's talk about the Axe ad. What were your thoughts on that one?
Well, to me, at the end of the day, a joke is a great surprise. And I don't think anyone really saw the end of that spot coming with the astronaut. And, you know, there's a lot of social tie-ins and things like that that people are adding on to their advertising these days. And I guess if you want me to tweet about something or connect with something with a chance to go into space, I actually went on and signed up myself. That would be a nice little thing to do.
Right, you're still expecting her to kiss the guy who saved her life there, and then the astronaut comes waltzing up.
Nothing beats an astronaut.
Yeah, nothing beats an astronaut. I mean, that's Big Joker. That's Trump right there.
New Axe.
Yeah, that
Apollo.
Is a very good ad there. And of course, the Oreo. They had a very good ad as well.
They did. You know, I think a lot of advertisers do well that just sort of play in the emotion of the day. It is a celebration after all. It is a good time for people to have. And I think, you know, a whispering car crashing through a library is, you know, it plays well for this audience.
And I forget the actual line they had when the lights went out in the Superdome. This was brilliant too. Oreo tweeted just a one single image ad with like an Oreo cookie with a little spotlight on it. And the rest of it was like darkened down. And I'm forgetting the line now, but
still
they were
the
on
dark.
It. What was it?
You can still dunk in the dark.
You can still dunk in the dark. Keenan saves the day there on that one. But I mean, that's somebody who's really thinking, taking advantage of social media.
Yeah, it's everything.
Yeah.
You know, you think about how we watch this game anymore. My computer was open. I was on Twitter. I was on Facebook looking at how my friends react. And when you can manage all the screens at the same time as a brand, I think you're doing well for yourself.
Absolutely.
All right, Michael, thank you very much for your
time. Thank you for your time.
Campbell Ewald, expertise again. We appreciate it.